Okay, so in this video, I'm going to look at using Gemini Pro with LangChain using a Google AI Studio API key. So just quickly, the things I'm going to cover in here, I'm going to basically show how you set up the LLM with LangChain, how you can actually do like a simple chain with LangChain. Then also we'll do a sort of little mini RAG system using both the Gemini Pro model and also the latest Google embeddings model that's in there as well. And then we'll have a look at using Gemini Pro for something like PAL, for a PAL chain. So that's a program-aided language model chain in there. And then finally, we'll wrap it up with looking at some multimodal things of how you would actually pass in an image using LangChain. So some of the things that I've done already in the previous video, but now we're going to look at actually how you could do it in LangChain and then use it for building LangChain apps, etc. All right, so I'm bringing a few different things here. Some of you probably not going to need all the ones that I've brought in here. I've been playing around with a few different things, but you will need to have a few sort of key ones. One of the key packages to install is this LangChain Google Gen AI package. So I think this is one of the first sort of third-party packages that LangChain is doing now, where the language model stuff for this is in this particular package, not in the core LangChain library anymore. All right, I've got that set up. I've got my secrets here in Colab. Remember just to put your Google AI Studio API key into the secrets, then you can access it like this. Obviously, I've run this notebook already, so it's not asking me for permission. It's already got permission to do this. And then I can have a look at the list of models that we've got here. So you'll see that this is basically what we had in the previous video. So we've got the old legacy text bison models. We've got the old embedding Gecko model, and then we've got the Gemini Pro model, and then Gemini Pro Vision, and then the embedding 001 model in here. And then the attributed question answering model, I'll do another video for that. All right, so if we're just using the straight up normal API, this is how we would do it. So we looked at doing this in the previous video, where we're basically just going to get the model to be Gemini Pro. I'm passing in a prompt. And you can see that then I'm just taking that prompt, printing out the markdown, and we can see, okay, I am a large language model. What did we ask it? Who are you and what can you do? I'm a large language model trained by Google. I'm developed by Google Brain Team. I think it's actually the Google DeepMind team nowadays. They've changed their name. But anyway, then it goes through some of the things that it can do, et cetera. And obviously this will change each time that you run it as well. So, okay, if we want to do the same kind of thing in LangChain, what do we need? So the main thing that we need is we need to bring in this chat Google generative AI model. So from here, we can basically tell it that we want to use the Gemini Pro API or the various Gemini Pro APIs. And you could imagine it's going to be the same for other Gemini models going forward here. All right, so I'm basically just defining the LLM. And this is sort of just like a key replacement of what you would do if you were using OpenAI or something like that. And then just in this one, I'm just basically saying to it, okay, just take the model and let's pass in a prompt. So we're going to invoke the model there with the prompt. And you can see that we're getting back something kind of similar to what we got before, where we've asked it, what is an LLM? LLM stands for large language model. We've got the whole result back. You notice that it's returning back markdown. So that we're getting some things that we're getting bullet points, we're getting bolded text, we're getting a number of those things in there. Just like with the other one, you can stream in here. This is just basically passing it through. It won't always pass back one chunk at a time. It will tend to do a number of chunks and pass them back depending on the speed of it, etc. All right, so the next thing we want to do is look at building sort of like some different chains going on here. So here we're going to make our chain where we're going to have just the joke chain, a very standard sort of LangChain thing. We're bringing in chat Google generative AI so that we can set up the Gemini Pro model. We're going to pass in a temperature of 0.7 in here. And then we're going to just have a chat prompt template where we're going to pass this in, tell me a joke about, and then we can change the topic. We're also going to have an output parser. And we're also going to be using the LangChain expression language to put this all together. So you can see here our chain is going to be a prompt piping or passing into the model, taking the output of the model, passing that into the output parser, which is going to convert it back to a string, and then it will just print it out in this case. So if I go through here and I run each of these, we should see, now tell me a joke about machine learning. Okay, why did the machine learning algorithm go to the doctor? It had a kernel panic. Okay, so not the best jokes, but it's certainly doing what we're asking it to do in here. All right, so let's move on and have a look at a little bit more complicated sort of chain. And this is kind of like a mini RAG in here. So now we're going to be using the Gemini Pro chat model. So we're going to be needing the chat Google generative AI, but we're also going to be using their new embeddings. So this is Google generative AI embeddings in here. We're going to basically we're not going to use a vector store to save to disk or anything fancy there. We're just using this sort of array and memory search vector store in here. And we're going to pass in a number of different things. So you can see here, I've got Gemini Pro is a large language model, was made by Google DeepMind. Gemini can either be a star sign or a name of a series of language models. A language model is trained by predicting the next token. LLMs can easily do a variety of NLP tasks as well as text generation. So this is what I'm going to embed, right? Each of these is like a little mini document that we're going to embed in here. So I'm passing in the embedding that we've got here. So we're using this Google generative AI embeddings, and the model that we're using is embedding 001 here. So we're passing that in. So that's going to be our embedder model that's going to do the embeddings for us. And then we're going to just set this up as a retriever, so that we can basically ask it questions and it will retrieve back these documents, but in an order that's going to be based on what our search is. So you'll see that if we just ask it, just what is Gemini, going to probably go more for the star sign, right? So Gemini can either be a star sign or a name of a series of language models. And then it comes Gemini Pro there. If I ask it, what is Gemini Pro? You'll see that now it comes back with the Gemini Pro at the top there. So this is the most relevant query that it's finding based on the embedding lookup in there. All right, so we need a prompt. So the prompt here is a very simple one. Answer the question as based only on the following context. We're passing in the context, we pass in the question. That gives us our prompt. We're going to chain all of this together using the LangChain expression language. So I'm going to bring in runnable map here. I'm not going to go too much into detail of what, you know, actually each part is doing here, but we've basically got this runnable map so that we can pass things through. We're going to have the context be the retriever taking in the question, right, from our prompt up there. And then that we're also going to pass in the actual question in here as well. Then we're going to pipe that into the prompt, pipe that into the model, pipe that into the output parser. So that's going to be our chain here. And you'll see that if we ask it, who made Gemini Pro, it should come back Google DeepMind. And sure enough, it came back Google DeepMind. Now, if we wanted to get the answers back, say, as a full sentence, right? So we'd come up here, we change the prompt, answer the question as a full sentence, comma, based only on the following context. So you'll see that now if I run through with that new prompt, I should get the same sort of answer back, but now as a full sentence. So I've got Gemini Pro was made by Google DeepMind in here. What about if I want it to get back, let's say I want to do something like return your answer as JSON. All right. So we want the answer back in JSON. All right. I run through the prompt. So I've adjusted the prompt here, asking the same question. And you can see now I'm getting JSON and I'm getting back like a JSON dictionary here where answer equals Gemini Pro is a large language model made by Google DeepMind in there. And we could play around with this. We could also say, yeah, return your answer, let's say, in 3 back ticks. All right. And you see now we're getting the answer back with 3 back ticks, new line, answer, new line, 3 back ticks in there. So you can actually put things like your formatting and stuff like that in here as well as, and obviously if we were using, we could use the JSON output parser to actually get back a dictionary and stuff like that. So some of those things I've looked at in the past in some videos, maybe I'll look at doing some new videos about that if people are interested in more stuff on the LangChain expression language. All right, so we've done that one. One of the ones that really sort of shows off, you know, the strength of a model is the PAL chain. So the PAL chain used to work with a very specific model at OpenAI, which they deprecated. And with the 3.5 model, it was tend to be, you know, sort of hit miss of whether it works, whether it doesn't work. So if we try this out with, Gemini Pro, we can actually see, okay, can Gemini Pro do this? So I'm passing in, basically the cafeteria had 23 apples. Remember the PAL chain is program aided language model chain. What it will actually do is turn whatever the question is into a Python function and then run that Python function and return back the answer for that. So you can see here, we had 23 apples. This is a standard one I've used a lot. 23 apples minus 20 plus 6, it should be 9, right? Because it's turned it into a Python function here. Cafeteria had 23 apples. If they used 20 for lunch and bought 6 more, how many apples do they have? Apples initial 23, apples used 20, apples bought 6. It turns it into a math equation and then returns the result. And sure enough, it basically gives us the result out there being 9. So one of the ones that a lot of the models used to get wrong was this time one. And it's interesting that this one kind of understands, you know, it's interesting to sort of see what it actually gets here. So let's look at the question. If you wake up at 7 a.m. and it takes you an hour and 30 minutes to get ready and walk to school, at what time will you get to school? So it should be 8:30. So we can see that it's got minutes, it's got this. The arrival time, it kind of gets it right because it's saying like 8.5, which probably means 8.5. So you could translate this as being wrong or right, depending on what you're doing here. But it's certainly better than a lot of models, which will either just throw an error with this one or will return back, you know, some random number in here. So this is definitely a good sign to see that some of these PAL chains are actually working quite nicely with the Gemini Pro model in here. All right, finally, let's have a look at how you would do multimodal stuff. So here I'm just bringing in a picture, bringing the same picture from the video before of the Earth. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask it, so I'm going to basically ask it a question about this picture. I need to make sure that I'm bringing in this Google Pro Vision model here, that I'm not just using the text model. Obviously now I'm doing the vision model in here. And one of the key things here is that I'm passing in a URL with this. So now I could, here I'm passing in this sort of public URL. I actually have a few different choices in here. I could pass in a public URL. I can pass in local URL. So if I've got it on the drive, I can pass the path to that. I can also pass in a Google Cloud storage bucket URL if I've got it set in there. So that would be quite easy, you know, if you're doing an app and you've got people giving you images, you would upload those to a Google Cloud storage bucket quite easily, and then you would get that return path and then be able to do any Q&A that you want over that. That's obviously going to help be quick with the model as well. In this way, the model is actually downloading the image from the internet as we go through it. The last one thing that you could also do is you could do a Base64 encoded image and pass that up as well in here. So I'm basically just passing this in. You can see that I've asked it, okay, what is in this image and who lives there? The image shows the Earth as seen from space. There are clouds, land, visible water. There are about 8 billion people living on the Earth. So it's answered what I asked there. So there are a bunch of different things that you could do with this kind of thing. Maybe we'll look at in the future if people are interested in doing a sort of multimodal RAG where we could actually have, you know, images being looked up and doing things where we could ask it questions and get it to find different things like that in here. But anyway, this gives you a sort of quick sense of how to use LangChain with Gemini Pro and with the Gemini series of models to be able to build apps and get various tasks going with this. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.